What if we freeze humans for 100 years? As of 2015, in three facilities in the US and Russia, there were around 300 people teetering on the cusp of oblivion. They exist in a state of deep cooling called cryopreservation and entered their chilly slumber after their hearts had stopped beating. Before undergoing true cell death, the tissues of their brains were suspended using an ice-free process called vitrification. All are legally deceased, but if they could speak, they would likely argue that their remains do not constitute dead bodies at all. Instead, in a sense, they are just unconscious. In this video, we're going to look a bit closer at cryopreservation, what exactly happens, and what is the likely outcome. Around 1,250 people who are still legally alive are on cryonics waiting lists, and new facilities are opening around the world all the time. No one knows if it's possible to revive these people, but more and more of the living seem to believe that uncertainty is better than the alternative. Many futurists believe that in the next 30 to 50 years, mankind will learn to cope with any causes of death. Physicians will treat and rejuvenate the body cells. It means that if a person is injured in a car accident, they'll simply repair damaged organs. People will even stop dying of old age or death caused by the natural deterioration of the body. The cells and organs can be rejuvenated. This way, the people of the future appear to be young, healthy, and immortal. We obviously want to be in this future, but most of us don't have a chance to live long enough to see it. If there is a fair bit of skepticism out there about the whole science of longevity or living forever, there's even more so about cryonics. Cryonics is probably best known for showing up in films like 2001: A Space Odyssey, Vanilla Sky, or the television series Futurama. The idea of inducing metabolic stasis in humans using cryogenic temperatures was proposed in the 1960s as a way of preventing structural decay of the brain following terminal failure of the body. Indefinitely preserving the brain's physical state was thought to leave open the possibility of resuscitating consciousness. In other words, by restoring function to the brain using one of the several theorized but as of yet undeveloped techniques, such as digital reconstruction or nanobot cellular repair. The idea of the technology has long been to freeze the human body shortly after being pronounced legally dead, replace the blood with a solution designed to preserve the organs, and then adding a so-called cryoprotectant solution that freezes cells without causing crystal formation, in the hope of minimizing structural damage. Then, the body is kept in cold storage at minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit until the technology has developed enough to successfully revive the body. The trouble is that this might, of course, never actually work. Scientists who study the effect of freezing temperatures on living tissues for procedures like in vitro fertilization, stem cell therapy, and organ transplantation say that there's no current way, no proven scientific way, to actually freeze a whole human body down to that temperature without completely destroying the tissue. When scientists attempt to freeze a sample of living human tissue, like a slice of liver, the tissue is completely obliterated, the cell membranes completely destroyed. So there's actually no proof that you are preserving anything, and this is because the science is just not there yet. There are animals that can survive being frozen and thawed, like Canadian wood frogs, but these organisms have evolved specifically to handle the pressures of freezing temperatures in a way that our bodies haven't. Shannon Tessier, a cryobiologist with Harvard University, says, "It's hard to imagine how our tissues could even withstand the process of being rewarmed, even with the benefit of a few centuries of scientific advances." Whilst conducting an experiment in the lab to vitrify a whole pig heart, she added, "The heart cracked in half due to not being able to warm it fast enough." But not everyone takes a critical look at cryonics. The Cryo Russ company was established in 2006, and today it has 250 contracts and 53 people have already been frozen. Other contracts are signed with people who want to be cryonically preserved after death. There is a choice to have the whole body frozen or just the head or even the brain. It's assumed that in the future, the organ or part of the body can be attached to the robot or to the donor human body. An 84-year-old teacher decided to store her brain and registered in the contract that she wants to come alive as a cyborg. The idea of cryonics went into practice for the first time 50 years ago. On January 12, 1967, James Bedford, an emeritus professor of psychology at the University of California, became the first person to be cryopreserved. A small team of doctors and other enthusiasts froze him a few hours after he died from cancer. A few days later, the team placed the body into an insulated container packed with dry ice. Later still, Bedford was immersed in liquid nitrogen in a large Dewar container. 15 years on, after a series of moves from one cryopreservation facility to another, his body found a home at the Alcor Life Extension Foundation in Scottsdale, Arizona, where it still resides. A visual evaluation of Bedford's condition in 1991 found that his body had remained frozen and suffered no obvious deterioration. But as promoters of cryopreservation celebrate the 54th anniversary of Bedford's death and freezing, known to some as Bedford Day, they emphasize improvements to the freezing and preservation procedures that Bedford's experiences advanced. But assuming cryonics does wind up working, for the newly reborn citizens of the past, there would be more to their stories than simply opening their eyes and declaring a happy ending. Instead, they would immediately face the challenge of rebuilding their lives as strangers in a strange land. How that would play out depends on a host of factors, including how long they were gone, what kind of society they returned to, whether they know anyone when they are brought back, and in what form they return. Answering these questions is a matter of speculation, but experts have spent time turning them over. If it were the case of just 30 or 40 years before returning, then you would know people, such as grandchildren, so having company would not be such an issue. If, however, it was 100 years, then it may be a lonely place to be, unless of course you had all your family frozen together. If cryogenically revived people came back to an advanced future, the mental flip-flops required to that new world would be substantial. Dislocated in time, alienated from society, and coming to grips with the certainty that everyone and everything they had ever known is irretrievably lost, they would likely suffer symptoms of intense trauma. What do you think about cryopreservation? Would you consider being frozen in time? Let us know in the comments below, and please like this video if you've enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this one, then subscribe to Brain Impact for more. Thanks for watching.